Nature is mesmerizing. The more we try to understand it, the more curious we get. And this is what happened during my last trip to Shimla. It was very cold. I was sitting in a hut and it was snowing outside. I got very excited and went out to experience it. It felt eternal. I was engrossed in the moment and was trying to focus on snowflakes. Suddenly, a snowflake fell on my glove and ting! Curiosity kicked in. How was this snowflake formed? Why does it have such a unique shape? Are all snowflakes different? What is the science behind it? So here I am with this video, where I will take you to the snowland and make you experience the mind-blowing snowfall and the science behind it. Stick till the end and I assure you, you won't freeze. You might think that a snowflake is similar to an ice cube in our refrigerator, but that is not true. An ice cube is formed when the liquid freezes into ice. Snowflakes are formed when water vapor in the atmosphere directly turns into solid. When an extremely cold water vapor comes in contact with dust and freezes on it, ice crystals are formed. And when those crystals start sticking to each other, water vapor freezes and sticks on them, building new crystals. And this creates a snowflake. It requires two conditions for a snowflake to form. One, the atmospheric temperature below 0 degrees Celsius, and two, sufficient moisture in the air. When the required temperature is very low, the water vapor that would normally condense into cloud droplets changes directly into ice. If the ground temperature is at or below freezing, the snow will reach the ground. However, if the ground temperature is above freezing, the snow can still reach the ground, if the conditions are just right. So now, look at these snowflakes. Do you see any similarities or any differences in these? Probably yes. All of these snowflakes have six sides, but all of these have really unique shapes. Not just that, scientists believe that no two snowflakes can be the same. Yeah, you heard it right. And there are almost 10 raised to the power 34 unique snowflakes in the world. But now you must be wondering, how do we know that? There is quite a possibility that a snowflake in Shimla might have an identical twin somewhere in Russia or Antarctica. How do scientists know it for sure? To understand this, let me tell you a story. A long time back, a 20-year-old boy, Wilson Bentley, was sitting outside his farmhouse with a feather and a black cloth in his hand, waiting for a snowflake to fall on the cloth. Before it melted, he put that snowflake under a microscope and then pressed the shutter. Yippee! Wilson Bentley just captured the first ever photograph of a snowflake. And that was just the beginning. After that, Wilson Bentley captured photographs of snowflakes for 50 years. And he called them masterpieces of design because he observed that no two snowflakes were the same. All of them had some differences. Just like each one of us has a different fingerprint. To know why, we need to go deep inside a snowflake. So a snowflake is made up of water, of course, and water is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, known as H2O. Each hydrogen atom has one proton and one electron, whereas each oxygen atom has 8 protons and 8 electrons. Thus, a water molecule has 10 protons and 10 electrons. The two electrons of hydrogen and oxygen are shared as they bond together. This type of bond is known as covalent bond. Now 4 electrons are left. They form 2 pairs as well. So now we have 4 pairs of electrons, 2 pairs of bonded electrons and 2 pairs of unbonded electrons. The repulsion between the unbonded pairs is stronger than the repulsion between the bonded pair. And hence, the unbonded pairs push the shared pair and reach at the angle of 104.5 degrees. That's how a water molecule is formed. One interesting thing to note is that the water molecule as a whole is neutral. But as the oxygen atom has more electrons, it becomes slightly negative and hydrogen becomes slightly positive. here comes the interesting part. When the temperature drops and water freezes, due to the negative charge of oxygen and positive charge of hydrogen, the oxygen in one molecule is attracted by a hydrogen in another molecule. A weak bond called hydrogen bond is formed, and the process is continued for every molecule, ultimately forming the hexagonal structure. This is the beginning of a snowflake, and it retains its hexagonal shape as it grows. As the snowflake moves, the water vapor molecules stick to its six edges and expand the snowflake outward. Now we know why a snowflake has six sides. But the main question is still unanswered. How do they have different shapes? A forming snowflake's shape depends on multiple factors like humidity and temperature. As the snowflake falls, it experiences different conditions, and that affects how it grows. Even a small change in this parameter will change the shape of a snowflake, and hence, it is almost impossible to have two similar snowflakes. But scientists still don't have the exact proof of it, and if you are still curious, then you can also spend the rest of your life capturing the photos of snowflakes. Thanks for watching this video. If you are curious to know any other interesting facts, then do write to us in the comments. Until then, I'm moving on to my next trip to bring some more interesting stories to explain.